In this video, we are going to concentrate on a manager and assistants. How an assistant can work in a very efficient way with a manager. In my company, I have two assistants, and they need to work with me in a way that all of us knows exactly what's going on. It might be that I sent a proposal to someone, and this person just replied to me. Now, if my assistant's supposed to follow up on proposals, my assistant will not know what's going on with my mailbox. So my assistant will need to ask me if I got a response from John. And then what's the point? I can do the follow-up by myself. So that will be one thing, and those will be follow-ups that my assistant's supposed to do for me, but the assistant have no way to be efficient unless she can see my emails. And that's what we are going to do right now. So I will have here one mailbox, and that will be my mailbox as a manager. The other one will be Jesse's. Jesse's will be my assistant. So in this case, let's assume that Jesse needs to see my mailbox. Yeah. So you go to the admin console, and I will go to the users. I will go to my user. My name is my precious one. No one sees here Lord of the Rings, obviously. And from here, I will have the delegation. So I will go to mailbox settings, and I will have delegate to. The delegate to allows me to add Jesse, for example, and then I can give Jesse permissions. In my company, for example, I'm going all the way, so my assistants can send on my behalf. They can be me, which means they can see my mailbox, they can send emails, they can do everything. In this case, if you just need your assistant to see the communications back and forth, you will have the read option, and I will add it. On Jesse's side, you will see here that on the bottom, Jesse have her mailbox, but now she can see also mine. So she can toggle between the mailboxes. So that will be my mailbox, and that will be Jesse's. So if Jesse needs to go to my mailbox, she will click here. She will see exactly what I see, and she can search different mails, and she can click on them. Now, as you can see, there is no way here to send the emails, to do anything like that. So in that case, Jesse can see my emails. She can see if someone responded to my proposal, if I took action on anything that she's working on, and then she won't need to take care of that. So this is one. Another scenario will be that I will need my assistant to book appointments on my behalf. In that case, I will go to my calendar. I will click on the three dots beside my calendar, and I will click on share. Okay, so Jesse will be my assistant, and I can give her or full delegation, or I can let her see only when I'm busy or not, if I don't want my assistant to know too much about me, or view the event details, or edit the event details, or delegate. In my case, it will be delegate because they can book appointments, they can change appointments, they can do everything. So I will click on share. In that case, if I will go now to Jesse's calendar, you will see a shared account, shared calendars. And now she can see me. And whenever she's booking an appointment, she can choose if to create the appointments on my behalf on hers. And now if I click here, we'll have here some appointment with James. And I will also talk to you one about that in a second. Okay, so now when it's booked, and then you can see, I can go to here and I can see that the appointment that was booked. So everything is being synced properly. Now, whenever my assistant is working, she might assist multiple managers. Then in that case, she can remove the check mark from me, and then she won't see my calendar. And you will have many calendars. There is no problem. You can have many calendars for each one of the managers. Obviously, I didn't set up my account. This is a new, fresh, by the way, Zoho One account. I didn't update the names. This is why you see Jesse with lowercase and user one and not my real name. So, but just so you know, you can update that as well. Whenever you're booking appointment, just one thing that is important, instead of just saying appointment with and the person name, I would have both names. So it will be appointment with Leo Isaac and James Dean. Okay. The reason is that whenever you are sending an invite to James, James will see the appointment with Leo Isaac and James Dean. Many people, they are just writing appointment with James Dean instead of Leo Isaac and James Dean's. So for me, it's awesome. I see James Dean. But James see in his calendar appointment with James Dean. Doesn't make any sense. So in those cases, I like to have the full name, and that makes more sense. The third thing that I want to show you, it's in case that your assistant and you're supposed to sync on different follow-ups. In that case, you have the to-do section. The to-do section will have groups. The group will allow you to have multiple people on the same board. So I will have here, let's delete this one. And I will have here, let's say, Jesse and Lior. And right now I am on Jesse's account. So she will invite me. And now both of us will be on this board. That will allow Jesse to create tasks here. So let's say I click on the plus button. I will write here, send SEO report to James. If I want, I can assign it, or she will assign it to me, or I can create task and assign it to her, which means both of us working on the same thing. What I like about this approach, when you have small tasks, and those are not projects, those are small tasks, things that's supposed to be done, send a proposal, do this, do that. All those can be done from one place, and I don't need to ask my assistant what's the status with that. Because you can have your different stages and you can choose whatever stage you want. And also when I go inside of the task, we can have comments. So Jesse will say, I sent an email to James and no reply. I will try again tomorrow. And then there will be a comment that's done, and there will be also a reminder for tomorrow. Okay, so tomorrow at 8 a.m., there will be a reminder to send another email to James. In that case, I don't really need to ask my assistant what's going on. I do know. My assistant will work with the board. I will like her to move items to the right place. And I also like to have a due date. So if I know that the due date is tomorrow, I don't ask questions because I know that it's in work. If I see an old due date, I know that no one touched it. So that's a very good way for me to work with my assistant. One more thing. Whenever I'm in meetings, I will take notes. It's part of my job. In that case, I will go to the notes. I will create a new note, or this is my assistant space. So she will create a note. And let's say the note will be the client, James again. Sure, we have only one customer. So James, and let's say it will be, I like to have one note for the customer. So I will have just all the data in one place. So meeting Feb 13, 2025. And here I will have the minutes, okay? ABC, and here I will have something else, and we'll have everything in one place. Whenever we have those notes, I will share those notes with my assistant. Or in this case, she is taking the notes. She can share those with me. So I will go here to the right side, and she will invite me, my precious one. And now both of us can see everything. So I don't need to ask my assistant where it is. Now, because we also work with Zoho One, instead of having the notes on Zoho One, let's go to CRM. I will have here, I will click here, and I will grab the link to this note. And when I am working, for example, on a lead, I will just have in the notes section, I will just have a link to the notes versus having tons of data in the notes section, which I don't like. I don't like to go to a record and see endless data. Okay, I want to see what's going on. I click here and I can see the data. Okay, so this is one thing that you can do. Those will be the main things that I can give you from my experience of working with an assistant. In the following videos, we'll do more things about Zoho Mail, including migration, including security, more things. But that was the main thing for this video. We'll see you in the next one.